My birthday is August 4th. That means, when I was exposed to the bomb, and 7 years plus 2 days. Sometimes I'm so busy and forget my birthday, but that means I am the age of the average of survivors. Average of survivors, 83 years old. From there, I saw the city. And what I recognized was everywhere the lines of smoke for cremation. And then I was surprised Hiroshima was gone, completely disappeared. Maybe from the newspaper or, I don't know, adults, those people were saying, we want to have any grass or any plants for 75 years. But actually, I could see like 1 month later or so, so many weeds, grass, we Japanese say tetsuzogusa, you know. And then saw, oh, that was not true. It's a kind of rumor. And then so people were so much happy, and by we learned many people from outside of Hiroshima and offered trees. And we were so happy, just like a burnt out desert like city. And all the trees here were donated by foreign countries too. That we can see white oleander nearby. That was presented by America, Honolulu. And I'm so happy because it's like a dark pink color, Hiroshima oleander and the white one, and Hawaii oleander. It is a kind of a symbol. We understand each other and grow together and then work together. I remember, and I only heard rumor, but actually how I felt seeing those flowers donated later and the trees donated by other cities, that comfort and soothe our anguish and the sadness and the anger, I think. Wow, wonderful, completely reconstructed. But we shouldn't forget where I'm standing, like here, underneath of this ground, still unknown victims and the remains are. And always when I see foreign visitors come here and stand in the Peace Park, because and this is the site that they are sleeping. So that means you are one of the witnesses. I'm a witness of atomic bombing, but at the same, you are here and we share the same place, you see? So that means somebody comes here and should have responsibility to do something for world peace. I want to others feel how peaceful here. I want to say you have the hope, and you have hope to create a new cities, even though and your streets, towns were destroyed during the battle, but you can cremate such a peaceful new city like we did. And so I want to tell others, please learn both historical sad event, but at the same time, nowadays Hiroshima tells you, you can make your real ideal peaceful city. So Hiroshima can convey to size of Hiroshima's message, I think. Without knowing the real history of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, that continues until now, our invisible fear, like trauma, still stays. So because of that, learn and study and join ourselves, and then knowing is the first step of creating nuclear weapon, or abolish nuclear weapon. And then when I went to California, and I gave us my experience to the aged people, and they know about the World War II. And then after hearing my story, and those people, just all of them would cry and hugged me, and what they said, we did not know what happened, the reality. Until now, we were thinking dropping the bomb saved many people's lives. That was the right decision. But from now on, I changed my mind. Knowing is the most important thing and for creating peace, world peace. What we wish is all of the people have the same feeling, not repeat such kind of evil nuclear war anymore. So we are so eager to speak out, not to have such a disaster anymore. Then, you know, just focusing on, and then we could overcome hatred. That is a kind of a promise and for our late, the family already dead. Sooner or later, within 5 or 10 years later, will die. That time, I want to say, and that this world was so peaceful, is so peaceful. I did such a thing. But now, I cannot say we abolish all nuclear weapons. No, we cannot say. So because I want to ask people all the world as soon as possible. I'm the average of survivors age 80. I will be 83 on 6th of August. That means 10 years later, I don't know I can survive. It's very difficult because of that. I want to see the world and to abolish and to sign, all the countries sign the treaty of total ban of nuclear weapons.